to Medical Moron. I am your host, Ray Hanoski. So you're having lower abdominal pain. It could be a sign of appendicitis. You may want to stop watching this video and go see your doctor. If you decide to stick around, let's see if your symptoms and expectations line up. More after this. After your appendix is removed, how long does it take to grow back? A. It doesn't grow back. B. 6 to 8 months. Or C. The surgeon will graft a new protuberance to function as your appendix. Okay, let's look at the symptoms. True, as I talk, you may be thinking, I have this or that, and while true, you may have the symptoms, the question remains, was it properly diagnosed? Keep this in mind as I talk through the common symptoms. Right-sided abdominal pain may at times begin in the middle of the abdomen and radiate to the lower right, where the appendix resides. Two, the pain's usually sharp and consistent. Loss of appetite, diarrhea, nausea, constipation, and fever. These symptoms, although they can be dismissive, however, so important at the same time. Your caregiver will help you sort them out. Remember, only a proper in-person medical workup with a licensed physician can properly diagnose. What is the appendix? It's a hollow, tube-like protuberance about the circumference of a pen, about this circumference here, and about a third of the length. It's attached to the beginning of the large intestine, the cecum, of which the small intestine dumps into. If the appendix becomes irritated and inflamed, it leads to tremendous pain and usually emergency surgery. If while talking to your doctor you are recognized as a candidate for surgery, know this, the surgeon's decision to take you to surgery is not taken lightly.
Okay, so now we have your all squared away. Let's settle down here beside her. So I kind of pre-drew some of the, I know it looks bad, but I kind of pre-drew some of the colon and the structures in it so that, well, we kind of have a something to start off with. What we're looking for is Mcburney's point, and Mcburney's point is a location that Dr. Mcburney had found to be the general area, and because the appendix is mobile, the general area where the first incision needs to be made, where the pain is usually located, is called Mcburney's point. Okay, so in order to do this, you have to find the right superior anterior iliac spine. And right superior anterior iliac spine, not the inferior, is located here. So this is the pelvic girdle, or the iliac crest of the pelvic girdle. The superior iliac crest is here. Okay, comes down here, and then you get it kind of goes indent a little bit. That's the inferior iliac spine. So you want the anterior superior, which is here. This is the umbilicus. Now, he says draw a straight line from here to here, and then a third of the way is Mcburney's point. This is where your appendix should be, or where it's generally located, where the pain is most times. So, with that being said, let's just kind of go up this way here. We have the rectal sigmoid and the sigmoid, the descending, transverse, ascending, cecum. And of course, this goes into, it's kind of dumps into the small intestine, dumps into this area right here, which is your large intestine, the appendix being right here. So, doctor makes the incision right there. If he's doing it traditional method, it's just one incision. one here, one both here maybe, one here, maybe here if he's doing four, this laparoscopic. Once those incisions are made, he takes the trocar, which we kind of looked at earlier, which I think I made a mistake on her. Anyways, here it is. Trocar goes in, push it in, push it in, push it in, push it in. Once it's in, the stomach takes us out. And in here comes the camera or grasping instrument, and he uses that to manipulate and do what he needs to do. Once he has the appendix out and it's gone, then he sews up the incisions right here. If it's traditional, he'll sew up this here. Of course, he's trying to do a very fine job to leave you with little or no scars in a few years. Once it's sewn up, he'll put the liquid bandage on or little 2x2s or something like that, and off to the recovery room.
Having said this, you have the right to a second opinion. Having said that, be aware of your situation. If you're in pain, you're currently being diagnosed in ER as needing surgery, well, you may want to think again about this second opinion. Most surgeons have this basic knowledge, and the delay may cost your life. If the doctor has his own reservations about your diagnosis, he may order antibiotics and require further testing to rule out differing diagnoses. He may order some blood work, a CT scan, ultrasound, and of course, he does the in-person medical exam. Surgery. Unfortunately, for true appendicitis, this is your only option. Your surgeon may use the traditional technique. One incision, about this big, also called the open technique or traditional. Laparoscopic is three or four very small incisions. So what does this all mean? It means you're having surgery, and there is no other option. Assuming the workup has been done, the pre-op nurse will prep you for surgery, the OR nurse will interview you, they will take you into the room and introduce you to the team. Then anesthetize, prep, drape, hook up, and incise. Of course, there's procedural safety mechanisms built into this, but for the sake of this video, you'll need to watch my safety mechanisms in the OR. Once the incisions are made, the trocars and scopes are placed, the cavity is insufflated like a balloon with a monitored level of CO2. This is to the surgeon's discretion to keep you safe. The appendix is removed, and with grasping instruments, of course, they don't do it with their fingers. So they go through the trocar right here. And you can see the little tiny hole there. It goes into the abdominal cavity like this. Of course, it sticks out inside the belly. Now, this here area has got a balloon-like CO2. And then through here, maybe using grasping instruments like this, and they click around, they move it around, they're able. Take out the appendix. They gently remove the appendix, check for leakages and bleeding. They cauterize and get out. This is an extremely shortened version of the surgery. As you can imagine, it takes about 45 minutes to an hour and a half, all things combined. Of course, some are quicker, some are a little longer. The appendix, if heavily inflamed or the need arises, the surgeon may choose to make a larger incision and remove your appendix traditionally. He may also decide to leave a drain. Recovery room is your next stop. After an extensive OR to pack you nurse report, the patient's left for an hour or two, then discharged home or to the appropriate floor, pending surgeon decision. Expect to return to work in 1 to 3 weeks for laparoscopic or 2 to 4 for open appendix surgery. Expect to feel weak and tired for the next several days. You may be swollen and painful. This will dissipate with time. Often you have shoulder and upper thoracic pain, which may radiate to the back. This will also dissipate with time. Diarrhea, constipation, gas, headaches, this will all go away in a few days and gets better over time, not worse. Your doctor may include a diet and lifting restrictions. Now, very important, foul-smelling incision sites or drainage, elevated temperature, pain getting worse instead of better. These are indicative of infection and can be very serious. And in fact, it can be grave. Unless treated immediately, let your surgeon know and go to the nearest ER if you feel this is the case with you. I'm an RN, and in many cases, a moron. I mean, yes, I've had roughly 30 years nursing experience, based mostly in surgery. And yes, my goal is to help bridge the gaps in the medical system regarding knowledge between the healthcare givers and the patients, like yourself. But my gathering of information is from many sources. Although highly legitimate, they are still gathered by me. What I'm saying is, see your surgeon for the real deal diagnosis. This can be only in your best interest. So, until next time, please like, subscribe, and ring the bell icon. This is for your better health. You won't want to miss it.